then 5, then 13, and Steve eventually won or lost, whichever way you look at it. Lost.
He got to have a chat with not only the King Monkey, but also his ex-mate, his mate, ex and Spiral Carpet, Clint Boom. Let's see what happened.
Ian Brown, Clint Boone. I'm honoured to meet two giants in the music world. Good to see you. You well?
I'm honoured to meet you. You're one of my favourite presenters, actually. I must say that.
There
you
go. Seriously?
Yeah, totally.
Well, thank you very much, Clint.
I'm like 5'9". Thanks for that one.
No, no problem. No problem at all. Do you like my presenting style? Because Clint was a bit of a
so fan. Far, not too bad.
OK, well, let's see
what
how we go.
What else can you do?
Tell me at the end of the interview if you
can
enjoyed
you do this,
yeah?
Can you do this?
Oh, can I stand? Hang on, go on.
Grab the pack there. If you're going to do anything random, let's take a look.
Ready. What's this hand, yeah?
Yeah, we're going to need a medic on the floor immediately. Ian Brown just tore his hand off. No, I can't do that. I'm not that good. I'm not that good, Ian. I'm not that good. Right. But tell me what you think at the end of this, yeah? I want to know how you guys first met and how you remained such good friends over the years.
With money, wasn't it? Through money.
I think probably, yeah. I mean, 84.
Milling about 1980.
Yeah, we had a little band, me, Manny, and a friend of mine called Chris. Mm. Chris Goodwin.
Yeah.
We had a band called The Mill, and Brownie came along with Andy Cousins, didn't you?
Yeah.
To try and form a supergroup.
And Manny.
And we were all, I think we were a bit weird, weren't we, for what you wanted?
No, I think that I was just blagging you. I'd never sung before.
You still haven't, have you?
I haven't.
I only hear about the weird times. I mean, it's probably difficult to remember a lot of the times, but tell me about the most crazy thing you've ever done in each other's company.
1984, I think it was, and we were making music with, like, forklift trucks and dustbins and things like that.
How do you go about doing that with forklift trucks?
You get a microphone, you put it on the floor, set your machine to record, and you drive a forklift truck over it. It's brilliant. We were doing things like that.
I'd like to hear that a lot.
There's a forklift truck, I'll show you.
You know, I've always wanted to ask somebody this question. You've both been in the music industry for so long now. Do you find it difficult to get inspired nowadays? I mean, do you ever find yourself writing a track and going, oh, this is class, oh, shit, this is She Bangs, oh, this is Saturn V? Do you find yourself writing tracks you've written before?
I still got awe for all the creation.
Mm. Let me ask you something, boys. You're obviously aware that earlier we had a few of the other rival bands here to write down some questions that they want to ask the rival bands. Because it is about rivalry.
Is it rivalry?
Would you like to pick one of these cards?
Yeah.
And let me ask you.
I'd say them gold looking chains.
Oh, you would, they're the long ones.
Because you think I don't like them, but they're all right, lads.
Okay. You've trained all your life to become the ultimate martial arts experts. What would be your chosen school and style of fighting and why? From Goldie Looking Chain.
That's, I don't know, a bit of Kung Fu probably.
Kung Fu for Clint?
Yeah. I'd go with a bit of Capoeira.
Capoeira?
Brazilian martial art, and it's hidden within the dance, isn't it? It's a dance that comes from the sugar plantations.
Can you show me some? Because I'm not familiar with that style of...
I'll show you after, there's not enough room in there.
Okay. Well, yeah. I want to end this right now.
I was telling you something then. You was asking me about it. I was answering your question.
Sorry, carry on. Go
for it. It's a martial art that comes from the sugar plantations of Brazil that the slaves had, and it's a dance, and the martial art's hidden within the dance. Capoeira.
Is that the end of the answer now?
I'll talk all night if you want.
Go for it. Continue. In fact, let me move this out of the way and show me some of that martial arts. I want to see it, seriously. Up on the table here. Is there any chance?
Do you want knocking out from here? Or do you want me to get up there and do it?
That's it.
Thank you.
Game over. And that's where we cut the interview, because it got very ugly, and this show isn't about ugliness. What do you think of that?
That was a little bit peculiar, Steve.
A bit shocked, Steve.
Trust me, it got worse. You boys still full of energy?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Hold on to that, because you're going to need it. Right then, it's time to get our convoy rolling, because you've got to be a canvas at King's Cross for some of Wales' favourite sons, Goldie Looking Chain. Lads, I'll see you over there if you'll jump.